we expect our citizen developers to all be working within the Maker Studio environment and then collaborating with our Code-First developers. Code-First developers, their environment is the IDE, the Integrated Development Environment, right? And we want to make sure that there's a very fluid experience going back and forth where people who are comfortable in their own environment don't lose context of the business objectives of what the apps are supposed to go do. So to that effect, I'm excited to kind of show you the new VS Code extension that we've now built within VS Code natively. So here's an example. I've got an XML file here open within my Visual Studio environment. I'll go select the terminal window within Visual Studio. And sorry, I'm mistyping here as I speak. And if I type in PAC, which stands for Power Apps command line or Power Platform command line, and now when I type in PAC help, I can see all the different options. The other thing I can do is with this new command line tool, I can also authenticate to various different environments. So in this case, as an example, when I do an auth list, I can see that I've authenticated to various different environments with different credentials, as the case may be, both within admin and user capabilities as well. So here in this example, I'm going to go do a command called who am I in my Power Platform environment. And here it spits out my org ID, the unique name of that particular environment, the environment URL, the friendly name, in this case, it happens to be called Toyota Dev, and the user ID, the credentials that I used, along with my SID that I'm using to log on to that environment. All right, so here's a couple of things that we're going to go do now. We're now going to go create a new solution. So before we do that, before we go into new solution, we see it's an empty directory. All right, and what I'm going to do is show you exactly a test solution folder. And when I'm working with the solution in the context of a command line, it actually looks like this, right? It has a source code file, a folder in there, and a test solution CDS proj file in there. How do I create that on the command line? So here again, using PAC CLI, I can now go ahead and create, say, PAC solution init, right? This is just like the way you would create a solution in your web UI, right? And within that, I can now specify my publisher, all right, so the publisher name, and then my publishing prefix within that environment, along with the location where I want the artifacts, the solution artifacts, to be created so that I can go ahead and build it as it were. All right, so I'm now specifying the publisher name, the publisher prefix, and then I'm using the dash O as in the output of where the location of where I want this particular path to show up. All right. And I'm going to hit enter. All right. Oh, I made a mistake. So here, apparently, I only added one quote. I forgot to quote the other one. So let me retype the command again. All right. So now I'm going to go back all the way after, right after O, put in that quote there, and hit enter. And there you go. So now within this solution file, I now have the CDS proj file, just like the one before, and I have the SRC file. And if I go to the SRC file folder, I'll see an other folder. And within other, I have the customizations XML, all the various relationships, solution XML. So as I keep adding artifacts in the solution environment, I'll start seeing more. So let's go. Now I'm going to go create another VS Code instance in the context of the folder in question. So now again, here I see same thing. And now I can go ahead. So if I'm a PCF developer, now I can add some of my PCF controls directly in this context to be used in this solution, which can then be deployed directly and targeted to my Power Platform environment. But as you can see, the PAC CLI can be used for other things more than just rather than just only for PCF solution.